We know that the most obvious signal of life within the body is the breath. The Sanskrit name for this is pranavayu. Prana can be roughly translated as life. The source of life, prana, is pranava. This life force manifests itself as the aspects of creation, maintenance, and destruction within the human body. The sounds attached with these aspects are a, u, and m. These sounds are manifest inside the human body, just below the navel, at the chest, and above the throat. One need not go so far as to have an experiential realization of these sounds inside the body. Just uttering these sounds loud enough will create a reverberation at these very specific body parts. Even phonetically, the sounds are in the order of fully open mouth, partially closed mouth, and a completely closed mouth. So, the sound of pranava is a combination of a, u, and m. There are whole systems of yoga that make use of these three sounds in varying proportions to activate those particular locations and the corresponding chakras inside the human body. These three sounds, when uttered together, form the sound om. This process is called as gunasandhi in Sanskrit grammar. The sounds a and u, when mixed together, form the sound o. It is not because there is a grammar rule that you need to pronounce it this way. It is natural for the mouth to produce the sound O when mixing A and U together. It is because the mouth is physiologically arranged that way these grammar rules came about. When the sound A mixes with the sound E, it becomes A. When it mixes with U, it becomes O. You can try these out for yourself as a fun exercise. So yes, it is pronounced OM when you are using pranava as a word to address the divine.